Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Lauren. Thank you so much for watching. Today we're talking all things grungy and fall. I've just been super into the fall season this month and I don't feel bad about it. So I thought it would be fun to go through my collection and find some palettes that have some grungier fall vibes. Like think of your Pinterest boards of fall stuff. Think of rock stars. Think of emo stuff. I don't know. I'm just like trying to go grunge and I don't want to buy stuff naturally. I'm trying really hard to rein it in as always, you know, just trying to use and enjoy the things that I have. So I shot my stash, I went and found some palettes and I thought I would share them with you and swatch them out and kind of get excited with you guys about them. I really hope it inspires you guys to look within your own collection, see what palettes you have that will work for fall. Some of the stuff I'm going to be showing you is new, some of it is old. For some reason, I didn't really mention much about like what was PR, so make sure to check the description box and I'm also going to put it on the screen. I feel like I just usually do a better job than I did in this video, so I thought I would mention that. And if you have other palettes that I don't have, mention them in the comments. Let other people know because they might have them. I just highly suggest going in, swatching your stuff, getting excited about what you have because sometimes it can just feel like you want new stuff. But your old stuff's really good and awesome too. There's gonna be timestamps down below for your guys' viewing pleasure because I did do a tutorial on this look. So if you like tutorials, stay tuned till the end. And last thing, you guys, this is just part one of the grunge tour, okay? There's two stops on this grunge tour. Tomorrow I'm gonna be uploading basically like a part two to this idea and it is going to be all about grungy single shadows that are duochromes. You guys know my love of sparkle and duochromes and so I thought it'd be fun to gather up all of the grungy fall themed duochromes that I have because I do think they're a little bit different than some of the other duochromes. So if you guys are into that, definitely stay tuned and that video will be coming tomorrow. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking. I really hope you enjoy the video and let's get to swatching. Bye.
All right, guys, I thought I would give a little overview of some of the palettes we're gonna be looking at, just to tease you a little bit. I thought it would just be so fun to go through and swatch everything and just kind of get inspired by some fall vibes, some grungy palettes. I have some new stuff, I have some old stuff, so let's just get into swatching and appreciating and checking all this awesome makeup out. The first palette we're gonna look at is the Freja palette. This is from Oden's Eye, and this one's maybe a little bit different. It's very warm toned and I really love this one for fall. Basically these terracotta shades, even this really beautiful like cranberry, I think work really well for fall. Also for like summer too, you could make it totally work. I also really love the inclusion of some of these more like purple toned duochromes in here. Those are just so stunning and it's definitely a good one for any of those like monochromatic fall looks. So let's swatch this baby out. I think one of the things I love about this the most is that there's a lot of these ones with like dimension and duochrome shimmer to help top any of these if you want to. I really loved this color though for just like an all over one shadow grungy look. So definitely a good one if you want some corally terracotta vibes for fall. Next on the list is a newer palette and I think this one's so great for fall. It's the Urban Decay Stoned Vibes palette. I mean, first off, look at that packaging. I will take some time just to appreciate that. I love it. but inside is what really matters. And in here, I'm trying not to blind you with the mirror, but there are so many beautiful shades. I picked this because I feel like some of these more jewel tones are a little bit more muted, and I do think that that gives them a more grungy fall vibe than a jewel toned classic fall vibe, if that makes sense. So let's get to swatching. I've been playing around with this palette for a little bit now. And I have to just say, like, I really do think this is a pretty good one for Urban Decay, you guys. I think it's very pretty. All right, guys, so here is the palette swatched out. We have like a cream, and then all of these really beautiful like topper shimmery shades. And then I really like the two mattes that they've included that are deeper. So like this grungy brown and then this kind of grungy purple. I think they help grunge out all of the looks that you could do. The blue is probably the least like, it's more jewel toned. It is quite bright compared to everything else. But I think the most, like, grunge out of here is Bloodstone. It's so pretty. It has like a bit of a green shift, but a really strong red undertone to it. So that is the Stoned Vibes palette. Definitely a really pretty one. I will say Raw Energy though, it's just a little bit drier than all the others. But anyway, yeah, love this one. Next, we're gonna throw it back. So you might have this one at home. And I know I've mentioned a couple of times that this is a really great one for fall, but I'm gonna reiterate it here, okay? If you have this, and you're looking for a fall palette, the Jackie Aina palette is beautiful, and I just think these tones fall so well for this time of year especially. I love this duochrome. There's mattes, there's shimmers, there's colors, but it's still pretty neutral. It just really ticks so many boxes. So let's swatch this baby out. All right, guys, so there is the palette. I really feel like this is so well balanced in terms of color, and I feel like it works for just so many occasions. This one's so shimmery, but so is this one for like some toppers and some more glitz. There's this beautiful, I love the duochrome in here. I really just love that. Some really nice basic mattes, as well as, again, some of those colorful ones. So love this palette. And I think this would transition really well into holiday as well. Let's get into some green palettes. I have quite a few grungy green palettes that I think work so perfectly for this time of year. So next we have Kaleidos' Futurism 1 Sci-Fi Greens palette. This is just absolutely a perfect grungy fall palette. I do have a little bit of hard pan on this yellow shade, and I just want to say I've had I don't know how many of these yellow grungy shades, and they always they almost always get hard pan. I don't know what's up with that, but anyway, I want to swatch this one out for you guys. All right, so here is the palette swatched out. I mean, it's a very what you see is what you get. If you want those gold and olive grungy tones, I mean, this is the palette for you. It's like the epitome to me of like these olivey tones. So, and that black, this is the blackest black in my collection. I have a video swatching out all my blacks if you want to see it, but at that time, this was the blackest. I think it might still be the blackest. Just beautiful. And I love that it's small. It's very concise color story. It knows what it's doing, knows what it wants from life. Next on the grungy green docket, we have the Smoke Sessions palette from Melt. If you have this, this is like a grunge dream. It's so beautiful. You can really get quite deep with this palette, but you can go more of like, again, those more olive tones or a little bit more blue, or you could kind of mix them around, but definitely I think a perfect one for a grungy look. So let's swatch this one out. All right, guys, so here it is swatched out. I love how rich the two mattes in here are, and I really think it helps tie this palette together and just like give it a depth that helps make it really grungy and perfect for fall. These two colors make any type of halo eye with this palette just such a dream. I really do want to bust this one out again. I had a little bit of difficulty. I feel like I remember that when I initially got this palette, but I think since then I've definitely changed how I do my makeup a little bit, and I think that I could get even more enjoyment out of this palette nowadays. So I definitely want to bust this out, and if you have this, I think this would be a great one to bust out right now as well. The last more like full-on green palette we're going to be talking about is this one from Ofra. This is a newer one. It's their Empowered palette, and I actually did a tutorial over on their channel doing 5 looks with this. So if you want to check that out, I did that in collaboration with them over there, and I'll leave it linked. But this, I think, is a more like soft and subtle grungy vibe that you could get. I really do enjoy this, especially again, if you maybe are a little scared of color, you don't want to do something too vibrant. I think this one's a really great one. All the shades in here kind of have a soft sheen to them. Thank you.
All right, and there is the palette. It's really nice and soft. You're not getting a ton of depth with this one, but again, I think there are some really nice like one shadow looks in here, some great like inner corner pops without going too colorful, and I think it's a nice one, again, if you want something a little more subtle, but this definitely gives some like swampy, grungy vibes, if that's something that you're looking for. Let's do a few of these alter ego palettes. I have two here to show you. The first one is the Goddess palette. This is a dupe of the gold palette from Natasha Denona. So lots of beautiful colors in here. This is very fall to me, but in a more neutral-ish way. The shade Athena is, to me, the epitome of grunge. Like, on my skin tone, this is some grungy, grungy stuff. So really think this one's great. And obviously, if you have the original gold palette, I think that would be a really, really great one for fall. And some, like, fall glam looks. Like, very smoky, kind of like dark academia. I don't know. I really think this is a great, great palette for fall. And you might already own it. Or you might own this one. Like, oh my gosh, I love that. Grungy, sparkly blue. It's so incredibly beautiful. Oh my gosh. See, this on my skin tone is very kind of green yellow. It's kind of hard to show you my whole arm, actually. These swatches kind of overtook everything. But this is such a beautiful palette. There are a lot of like flakier textures in here. So I definitely would suggest using a glitter glue with those things. But personally, that's one of the things I love about this palette. I love flaky textures. I love being able to use a glitter glue and, you know, get that shine without actually having like plastic glitter. And that's what those shadows do for me. Really, really love this. I like already want to put it on my eyeballs. I really love that shade. and I wanted to say, I don't have the Natasha Denona. I want it. It's on my list, even though I have this palette. But I do think that this alter ego is a great option if you aren't wanting to necessarily spend the money for the Natasha Denona, if that's just not in your price range, but you want a similar color story. I do think that this quality is very, very, very good. So yeah, gotta love it. The other palette that I have from Alter Ego is the Artemis palette, and this is duping the Metropolis, which came out for holiday last year. This is a mega monster. It's so big. There's so much here, and I think you could go a lot of different ways with the looks in this palette. You could go more grungy, you could go more bronze. Like, there's just a lot of directions to go with this, so that's why I wanted to mention it in case this was maybe more up your alley or you like the idea of getting more shades in one. There are a lot of these, like, they're like cream to powder, which is similar to how Natasha Denona's is, so keep that in mind. They're buildable. I don't know. I just wanted to bring that up because I know maybe not everyone will like love that. I don't mind those actually though. So I'm gonna swatch it out. I don't know why I'm doing this. I'm gonna do like double swatches though because it's gonna like take up my whole arm. It really is. Oh my gosh, I did it. I did it. Okay, so trying to get it all in one shot. So here is the palette. I kind of got a little double helixy and started spinning around here, but so much is in this palette. I mean, we have some of the creams here, which are like this one, like these four I think are creams. That's a cream. Anything that swatches, I feel like a little bit lighter, is, I believe, a cream formula. And I do find that they can be buildable. So, you know, keep that in mind. But the deeper shades tend to look a little bit more brighter than you'd expect. There's tons of bronzes. I mean, these kind of look like fallen leaves. Like, I definitely get a lot of that imagery from this palette. I will say, this is a bit overwhelming for me personally, like there's just so much in here. I do tend to enjoy a little bit more of a condensed color story, but I do think overall this does give a lot of fall vibes if you're more into this. I personally suggest the Goddess palette. Also, I'm gonna be leaving like what's PR on the screen because I realize I haven't really been talking about that. I honestly just hadn't been thinking about it, and usually I try to mention that verbally, but I will put that on the screen so you guys can know as well, and I'll indicate it downstairs just in case. I don't know. I try to be good about that. So that's the Artemis palette. On to the ninth palette, and I wanted to show the Tiny Marvels palette. This is a newer release this year, and it's in collaboration with Sydney Grace and Mel Thompson here on YouTube. This is what it looks like. And honestly, I feel like this has a lot of room to be a lot of things. Like, you could use this for springtime. You could use this for summer. Maybe not as much winter, but yeah, I don't know. I could make an argument if I had to. But I do think it works well for fall with some of these colors. I especially think Scarab looks very fall to me. Even this like rose gold, I think plays so well into a more romantic version of fall. So let's swatch this one out. I do have a 3 looks, 1 palette with this. So check that out if you want some inspiration if you happen to have this. All right, guys, so here are the swatches. I mean, most of these are just like one finger swatches, so, you know, keep that in mind. But I have to say, every time I swatch and use the Sydney Grace shadows, the quality of these like truly is outstanding. The way that the mattes, like you can just see it. They're just so buttery and they just perform so well. The shimmers as well. I mean, Scarab, look at that. The duochrome on that is so beautiful, and it's one of those ones that if you sheer out, it's gonna be more red, and if you kind of pack it on, you can see that more blue-green on top of the red. They're just so beautiful. The shimmers are so beautiful, and I really think some of these like mauves and like wine type shades work really well for a bit more of like a romantic grungy look for fall. Really think this palette's beautiful. Number 10, we're gonna kick it with a drugstore palette. This is from NYX. It's the Mystic Petals palette. I more recently got this, and I will have a look, I believe, with this coming up on the channel, so stay tuned for that if you're interested. But there's something about this that is like grungy garden vibes for fall. I get a lot of like dark academia vibes from this. There's something kind of, yeah, dark and grungy about it, but it's a little bit different than some of the other ways. Like, it doesn't have those mustards. It doesn't have the terracottas. It's more cool toned grungy. So let's swatch this one out. All right, so here are the swatches. Lots of those mauve shades. We have some really pretty cool tone colors. I feel like this teal performs so well. It's quite deep. I don't think this palette is for you if you really want like shimmers. If you're like into the sparkly shades, this might not be the one, just because a lot of these shades are more like satins. They're not like super foiled. Where this palette really shines and I think works so well for fall are the matte shades. This is such a beautiful mauve-y matte. We have this really beautiful like purple gray, again, that teal, and then this deeper, darker charcoal gray, all so beautiful. And I do think that it complements the palette so well. So if you're looking for more of those types of mattes, I do think this is a nice palette. I don't know why like I turn into reviewing when I'm really just trying to show you what I have. I don't know what happens. Next, we have another more simple palette. This is the Aristo palette from Zoeva. And I think this is a really good one if you want something a little bit more subtly fall than some of the really grungy, really deep, like kind of rocker style ones that I've shown so far. I think this is a really nice one also because you can do like duo looks that can be a little bit more simple. It kind of does some of the work for you. Like these olive and this rusty shade. I think the blue is really pretty, but it's still kind of muted in a way. So this is a nice one for something a little bit more low key. You can totally see in the Swatches how this is more of just like a lighter grunge. I don't know how to explain it. It's like grunge on a diet or something. There's still like these classic, what I'd call grungy colors, but I feel like the way they're done is a little bit lighter, a little bit more wearable as well. So if you're looking for something more like that, this might be a good one. So far, I've been really impressed with the quality as well. I think that these two at the end as well, like these two duos, well, this duo and this duo work so well for something grungy. I've done a look with this one. I don't know, it's just so pretty. There's something understated that I can appreciate about this palette is what I'm ultimately trying to say. And I bought this one myself. All right, second to last, we have this holographic looking palette. This is from Ofra. We have another one that I feel is a little bit more understated in terms of its grunginess. This is the Glitch 2000, I believe. Let's see. Yeah, Glitch 2000, I'm so good. This was sent to me from Ofra, but I do think, again, if you want something a little more understated, if you're into more of those satin finishes, this can be a really nice one. There's some color in here, but because it's a satin finish, I feel like it helps kind of make it a little bit more low-key. So let me actually swatch this out like a normal person. So here is the palette, and I feel like the blue and the pink are showing up quite bright, but overall with this palette and why I put it in here is because there's this muted quality to like kind of all of the shadows. You know, even with these brighter ones, something about it has like this muted, grungy look. I also just love the idea of all of these as like single shadows buffed all over, really getting that grunge factor from the way you would wear some of these satins. The cool tones in here, like this one, this more mauve shade, and also the more gray, those also work so well for a more neutral, kind of like grungy eye. And I think you can see some of the texture on my fingers of how these are just like a really beautiful, like pearlized satin. And so I think there's something about that too that works so well as that like single shadow look. So that is the Glitch 2000. And the 13th palette, the final palette I have to show you. This one is a little bit more of like a bright grungy. So if you like color, but you still want a little bit more of like the fall vibes, I think that this one will be perfect for you. It's the Flare palette. And inside, this is what it looks like. So we're definitely getting a lot of color. I feel like as opposed to some of the other shadows we've been like looking at, don't mind the fact that my brown acorn is broken, unfortunately. I mean, even some of the names, there's pumpkin in here, forest pine, moss, cider. It is definitely the brighter, grungier palette if that's something you're looking for. So let's get this swatched out. Lots of mattes in here too. Like it has a lot of mattes. All right, so here is the palette. Definitely bright, right? Like it's like the bright version of fall. I also really want to mention how I like how this palette is broken up. So basically every row across is a really nice eye look potential. So we have like this kind of purple red top, we have like yellow oranges, and then blues and greens in the bottom. And so if you're feeling a little overwhelmed by the color selection in here, that's a way that you could break down the palette and it could help you, you know, create some different looks and have a starting place, I guess, to jump off of. I also want to mention, I have heard from people like kind of mixed reviews, I guess, of the Ace Beauté stuff, but from what I've had, I have enjoyed them. The mattes are like pretty dang pigmented, I find. I haven't had any trouble with them personally. As for the shimmers, they're more of like a thicker dimethicone-y kind of feel. Like they're, yeah, I guess thick, but I still think that they're really beautiful. So I bought this palette myself and that's it. I mean, this is like definitely the rainbow grunge fall palette. There's like something about it that just tweaked slightly for fall. All right, guys, let's get into the look. I'm super excited. I'm gonna be doing something really corally and kind of burnt. And yeah, it's just kind of the vibe I wanted to go with today. Get out of the blues and greens, at least for a moment, just for a moment. So first thing, I'm gonna be taking this light kind of matte coral shade and I'm gonna be running that all in my crease. Not like I don't know. I don't like to use the word sloppy because I'm not trying to be sloppy, but I'm kind of just putting that everywhere in the crease as a transition shade. I guess the reason I could say that it's a little sloppy is just that, you know, it's okay if you kind of buff a little over the edges and have like a lot of diffusion, if you will. And I'm making sure to get that in that upper brow. I'm not necessarily like taking it into the brow, but I do think that having it all the way up to where the eyebrow is, at the center part of the eye, helps to give a grungy look to any type of eyeshadow. All right, we have a nice wash of that going on. I'm now taking the same brush and I'm going into this kind of, it's like a mauve-y brown coral. And I'm gonna be putting that in basically the same place. I'm not gonna take it quite as far up since we just did all that blending. Like, there's no reason to do it again. And I'm going to be mostly focusing it on the outer corner, and then bringing it in as I have less product on my brush. This will add, I think, a lot of the grunge. The first color was a little bit bright, but I like how that's gonna look on the edges, and then this is gonna just start deepening it up. And I'm okay with like bringing this also as we're blending, like on the lid a bit, especially on that outer half. All right, so this is where we're at. I'm just taking same brush, and instead of using normal pressure, I'm going really far on the edge of the brush and just using the tip to kind of blend out, just going very softly since there's gonna be powder just kind of naturally left over in the bristles of the brush a little deeper. If you go a little lighter with application, you can blend out and kind of diffuse even with the same brush. Oh yeah, we're getting very grungy. It's like giving me Lime Crime Venus palette vibes. Like, that's where we're at right now. Next, I'm gonna be taking a, what I call a pinched fluffy brush. It's kind of like a shader brush, but it's like fluffier than that. So we're gonna go even more grungy. I don't know if I wanna go like red. I kinda wanna go red. I'm gonna go red. I'm gonna take that matte, it's pretty red. I mean, there's like a kind of a brown to it, but I'm just tapping this on that outer corner, just really punching up some of that color. That shade was so freaking pigmented. It's like a little brighter than I was maybe wanting, at least for this specific look. So I'm gonna take a smaller blending brush and I'm gonna go back in with the shade we were using, and I'm just gonna kind of add this to the outer corner a little bit over that red and see what happens. Okay, that's just where it's gonna be. We're gonna be really red, but I do think that adding the lid color is gonna tone it down a little. For the lid, I'm gonna take some glitter glue. This one's from NYX. You can use whatever you have, but I do suggest something that's gonna help stick shadows on. And I do like using a glitter glue as opposed to wetting the brush because I like a flaky texture, and I find when I am wetting a product, it tends to make it a little bit more foiled and more like metallic looking and like smooth. I don't know, okay. And I'm gonna be putting this mostly in the inner corner, but also bringing it back on the red a little bit as well. And I do one eye at a time. For the shade today, I kinda wanna go with this one and see what happens. I don't know, should we do that? No, we're gonna go with like this purpley duochrome. And I'm just gonna be tapping that on the lid and then blending out with my finger, like I always do. I definitely think that purple helps to add like a grunge element to this look. All right, so that's where we're at. I have the tiniest bit of fallout. I'm just kind of, I don't know, taking my brush and rubbing it away the best I can. I'm not gonna worry about it too much. I'm just taking a shimmery shade from another palette to do my inner corner. Use whatever you want. You can always use like your face highlighter. For the lower lash line, I'm going to be smudging some of the mauve shade that we used. It's not too red, which depending on how grungy you wanna go, you could go all the way red, but I'm just gonna be keeping that to the outer corner, add a little bit of depth, and I'm gonna be blending that up into the top lash. I'm taking the shimmery raspberry and I'm just gonna blend that onto the outer edge. I'm just using my finger to do that, and I'm tapping over where we put the lid shade down. And then naturally, I'm just gonna blend out the edges a little. All right, to finish up the lower lash line, I'm gonna take a taupey liner, and I'm gonna be running this on the lash line, kind of smudging it, but I didn't wanna go black because I felt like it would make it a little too harsh. Like, I still wanted it more grungy than like, I don't know, I guess emo. But I'm just gonna blend that out with a brush we already used. And I find when I really deepen up the lash line, it helps to differentiate the red from my eye so I don't look as sick and it looks more intentional. Although you can argue that like sick is part of the look. Now I'm taking whatever's left over on that pinched fluffy brush we already used, and I'm just running it under the lower lash line. All right, guys, I'm gonna add some mascara and we will see this look. All right, guys, so here is the finished look. I know you guys have already seen it, but let's zoom in so you can see an up close version. And here we are for this super blown out, like red toned, kind of smoky eye. I really love the duochrome because you guys know I can't get enough of duochrome. But you could definitely deepen this up with like a black or a taupe, keep it a little bit more smoky and not as bright, but I like the way it turned out. I was a little nervous at first, but definitely grungy. I would say this is grungy. The grunge is here. Okay. All right, guys, I really hope you enjoyed this grungy look, this grungy video. This is, again, part one, so stay tuned for tomorrow. We're gonna be looking at a ton of grungy duochrome shadows. My love of duochrome mixed with fall grunge. I'm really excited, and I'm gonna have a couple of looks in there as well, so stay tuned for that. I'll see you tomorrow there, and that's everything. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Bye.